We're starting a new krach, Chelik Yud Beis, Parshas Vayikra. This is the second sicha actually of Parshas Vayikra. This sicha here is a hadron on Masechta Menachos. This hadron the Rebbe said on Vav Tishrei Tovshin Lamed, in connection with the yard site of the Rebbe's mother. Usually on such occasions, the Rebbe's father's yard site, the Rebbe's mother's yard site, the Rebbe would say a hadron during the Fabrengen. This is actually the first sicha of the Fabrengen. The Rebbe began with the hadron. A very geschmacka hadron here on Masechta Menachos. Tanan b'siyim Masechta Menachos. Ne'ma ba'olas behema isherech nichoyach. It says in the Torah by the olas behema that the Eibshter accepts it isherech nichoyach. U'ba'olas ha'oiv isherech nichoyach. U'b'mincha isherech nichoyach. The Torah uses the same term for all three. For the behema, for the oiv, and for the mincha. So this comes to teach you echad amarve ve'echad amamit, whether you bring a large carbon, whether you bring a small carbon, as long as your kavana is l'shamayim, it's accepted the same way. Pirish ha-mishneh v'pashtus, the pshat of the mishneh is simple. The Torah uses the same expression of Isherech Nechayach by all three. Although they're not the same at all, a behemah is much larger than an oif, and an oif is much larger than just flour that's used in a mincha. So this proves that the size of the carbon doesn't matter. The main thing that matters is the kavana l'shamayim. Shema mamet mechavan libel l'shamayim kamaya marbe. If the person bringing a small carbon has the same kavana l'shamayim like the person bringing the large carbon, oz choshev amuet shaloi kamaya merubi shalchaveidai. His small carbon is just as significant like a person, like his friend that's bringing a larger carbon. Mitzarech lahavin. So the Rebbe has one question on the expression of the lashon of the Mishnah. Haloshen echad amarbe chulu, when the Mishnah says echad amarbe, v'loi loy melachosha filo oigam amamit ubulvat chulu, and it doesn't focus only on the one that's bringing a smaller carbon, but it says echad amarbe ve'echad amamit. It's focusing on both, on the one bringing the small carbon and the one bringing the large carbon. Mashma shegam ba'amarbe yesh chiddush sheshav la amamit. That the chiddush here is also regarding the person bringing the larger carbon. That his carbon is the same as the one bringing the smaller carbon. What's the pshat in this? The simple pshat of the Mishnah you would expect is that the mamet, although he brings a smaller carbon, is just as good as a large carbon. But from the lashon of the Mishnah is mashma that the chiddush is the other way around also. That the one bringing the larger carbon is just as good as the one bringing the smaller carbon. What's the chiddush in that? The pashtus is just as good. The pashtus would be even better. The Gemara Shamisal Mishnah Zu, then the Gemara says on the Mishnah, Omer Abzeire, my Kara, what's the Pasik that proves this idea that the Mishnah said? O Meshiv, Mesuka, Shnasa Oivid, Ma'atvim, Harbe Yoichal. And the Gemara brings the Pasik that it says in Koheles that the worker, his sleep is sweet, whether he eats a lot, whether he eats a little. As Rashi explains over there, this refers also to a person bringing a carbon that his schar is the same. Whether he brings a carbon that is a lot to eat or a carbon that is less to eat. Avada Barava Mamehocha, Avada Barava brings the raya from a different pasik, from a pasik that it says also there in Keheles, but Abay Satoive, Rabo Echleo. If you bring a lot of good, a lot of big carbons, and there's a lot to eat. But then the pasik concludes, Ma Kishrein Lebaleho. What advantage is there to the owner of the carbon that brings a bigger carbon with more to eat? This klal that it mentions in the Mishnah, it's learned out from these psukim that Rab Zeira and Avada Barava bring, not from the pasuk that the Mishnah mentions. Isherech nechayach. Tzarech lahavin. The question is, my shalosa shal Rab Zeira, my kora. What's bechlal the question of Rab Zeira when he asks, what's the pasuk? What's the source? The Gamay Chuvasam Shadab Zaidav Ravada Barava, and what is their answer that they both give? They are Fusi Mashakasav Mesuka Oi Birabais. That you learn it out from this that it says Mesuka or the Pasik Birabais. Hale Mefurish Bimishna Atzma Dechadamarba Yalfino Mizesh and Nema Isherech Nechayach. The Mishnah clearly says that the Raya is from the fact that the Torah says the same term of Isherech Chayach regarding all three. regarding the behemah, the oif, and the mincha. So why are we looking for any other source? If for whatever reason the raya of the Mishnah, that it says the same yisharech by all three is not enough, then kasha lidach kisa. So the question is on the other way, other hand. So why doesn't the Mishnah bring the psukim that the Gemara quotes? Kivin shehem hachachas maspikas, since they are a good raya. Mashenka nakasav yisharech nechayach, and the pasuk of yisharech nechayach is not enough of a raya. So the question of the Rebbe over here is memonavshach. Is the Mishnah bringing a pasuk that is good enough of a raya? So then the Gemara shouldn't be asking the question of my koro and bringing other psukim. Are the psukim of the Gemara dafka the raya, and the raya of the Mishnah is not a raya? So then the Gemara should not be the one bringing this. The Mishnah itself should bring these psukim. The Rebbe continues in the hemshach of the Gemara. The hemshach linyan anal b'gemara huve b'raisa. The Gemara brings a b'raisa b'va erez gimel onyan b'karbonis yesh b'em mishum chiddush. Three things that there is a chiddush regarding karbonis. Tanya omer abshimi ben azai. Boy, urei maksiv v'parshas karbonis shlenem b'em loikel v'loy alikim ela havaya. In the parsha of karbonis, by all karbonis, it doesn't use any other names. It only and always uses the name havaya. Why? So that a baldin, a litigant, should not be able to come and argue and say, what is he going to say? So Pirish Rashi. Those individuals that say that there's more than one God, chas v'sholim, and they're going to bring a riot to their opinion. There's one name that's brought in Torah, and that's the one that commands to bring a mincha. And then there's another name, another God, chas v'shalom, and he says, lahakriv leporin, and v'zeh elim, and then a third name to bring elim. So lakach nema b'kulam reich nechayach l'havaya. So the Torah writes by all the same name, reich nechayach l'havaya, that it's one name, the same Eibishter, that's telling us to bring all the karbanos. The second point it says in the Braise, v'nema b'shoyer agasi sh'reich nechayach, u'boif adaki sh'reich nechayach, u'bimincha yish'reich nechayach, it says by all karbanos. By a large shoyer, by a small bird, and even by a mincha, the same term yish'reich nechayach, to teach you echad amarbe, echad amamet, u'buvat, sh'yechaven, eslibe l'shamayim, like it said in the Mishnah. The third point the Braise says, v'shem ha'toyim alachilo hu'tzorech. Maybe you'll say regarding karbonis b'chlal, that Eibush is commanding us to bring karbonis because he needs our food. Talmud loymar, Eibush says, im erav, if I'm hungry, loyim meloch. I don't tell you that you should feed me. Kili seivul umaloya, the whole world belongs to me. V'nama kili kachay seyar behemis b'harari olav v'gaymer. All the wild beasts in the forest and all the animals on the mountains are all mine. The Eibush has enough bulls and enough goats to eat and to drink from them. You're not bringing the karbonis for my satisfaction. The karbonis are being brought for your satisfaction. All karbonis are being brought for your satisfaction. So the Rebbe has many questions on this braisa. Aleph, the first question is, the braisa seems to be including three points in one braisa which have no connection to each other. What is the connection of the three points here? He includes it all in one statement. And he writes it with a vav ha'mosif adding to the previous point. What is the connection between these three points? Seem to be three unrelated points. Beis, the second question is, looking at the first point that Abshim ibn Azai said, that it says the same name Avaya by all karbonis. Ma yoyil zeh, sheva karbonis nema rak shem Avaya, limnoya velitim pischem pele baldin lachlik. How is this going to help writing the same name Avaya by karbonis that now nobody could argue and say that there's more than one God, chas v'shalom? We find other mitzvahs. There it uses other names. And it also uses the name Avaya. So true, by Karbonis it only says the Shem Avaya, one name. So by Karbonis we see it's one God. But still by other mitzvahs it says other names. So if someone wants to argue that if you look in Torah you see more than one name, you still see more than one name by other mitzvahs, so what does it help? Gimel, the third question. Why are we referring to this individual that says that there's more than one God, Chas v'Shalom? Why are we calling him a Baal Din? The mitoy hazeh mashma, the labala nochazu, geder amachayev lova imay bedin udvarim. That this is an individual and his opinion that he has is someone that we have to have a conversation with, we have to talk to him about this. This is a person that's stam akayfer, stam denying the existence of one God. So why are we paying attention to him in this extent that we're calling him a Baal Din? That he's an equal, that we have to argue with him. Shaila Dalid, the Rebbe moves on to the second point that Rav Shimon ben Azai said. Ha'inyin ha'sheni shebedivrei Rav Shimon ben Azai, harei alochayre oisei inyin mamash oma b'mishnaseinu. The same exact point of Echad Amarba, Echad Amavet, Uvavad sheyichiv achavan libel ha'shamayim. It said it in the Mishnah, why is it being repeated again in the Braisa? Shaila Hay, regarding the second point as well. If it's the exact same point that it says in the Mishnah, so why does he change from the Lashon that the Mishnah says? Instead of using the term Oilas Behemah and Oilas Ha'oif, Oimer Shoir Agas V'Oif Adak. Rav Shimon ben Azai in the Braisa says the term Shoir Agas, a large Shoir or a small bird. Why does he change the terminology? Moving on to the third point of the Braisa. Shailah Vav. How would anyone even think to say that the Eibishter needs food? Rav Shimon ben Azai has to make a special statement and let us know that it's not the case, and he has to bring special rayas from Sukkim to disprove this idea. Who would think such a thing, that the Eibishter needs food? If, for whatever reason, it is necessary to negate this idea that Karbonis is about feeding the Eibishter, this should come as an introduction to all the halachas of Karbonis in the beginning of Masechta Zvachim. It shouldn't be brought only all the way at the end of Masechta Menachas. Another question on the third point of Rav Shimon ben Azai. B'shlilas Rav Shimon ben Azai is like a salka da'itach t'la'achilu hu tzarech. When Rav Shimon ben Azai negates the idea that the Eibishter needs the karbonis for food, eina oimer shalamayla ein shayachin shalachil. He doesn't say that there's no such a thing as food by the Eibishter. Ela, rather, what's the pasuk? She'im erav loy oimer loch ki li sevo v'goymer. When I am hungry, I don't turn to you to feed me. Hainu shekein shayachin shalachil kavayachal amayla. There is such a thing as hunger, kav yachol, by the Eibishter. El sha'oz loy ein malach. The Eibishter says, I don't need you to feed me. Vahatam kilichulu. And the reason is because the Eibishter could feed himself. But you see that there's an inyan of food lamaila. What does this mean? So the Rebbe asked questions on each one of the statements of Rav Shimon ben Azai here. And the Rebbe also wants to understand what's the flow of the whole braisa of the three different points that Rav Shimon ben Azai brought. And the Rebbe will answer everything over here in the Sicha. Let's see. Vahabir b'kolzeh. The explanation of all of this. And the Rebbe begins first to explain the difference as far as the statement of Echad Amarbev, Echad Amamet, Bulvachi Yechavan Libi L'Shamayim, the way it's brought in the Mishnah, and the source that's brought in the Mishnah from Ishereach Nechayach, and then the way it's brought in the Gemara, when the Gemara asks my Kara, and it brings other Psukim. Ha'hevdol Shabin Amarbev Amamet Bekarbim She'inyin Akarbin Hu. So the difference between a person that brings a large carbon or a person that brings a small carbon. So when you look at karbonis, there are two aspects in karbonis. Adam ki yakriv geimel Hashem, there's the person that brings the carbon for the Eibishter. So hu b'shnei tzdadim. There are two aspects to the carbon. Mitzad ha'adam ha'makriv, there's the person bringing the carbon. Ha'im huva ha'karbon al yidei ha'adam ba'ifn shal shleimus ha'ru'uyim mitzad ha'makriv, is the person bringing as much as possible, to the most perfect degree that he could bring a carbon, or he's bringing a smaller carbon. And then there's mitzad HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the way the carbon is being accepted from the Eibishter's perspective. In my carbon is kabul eratzin lamayla b'shlemus, is the carbon being accepted fully by the Eibishter? There are various levels that the Eibishter accepts a carbon. Well, derech, as you see in the Lashon of the Gemara in Zvachim, the Gemara describes a case when a person brings a carbon and he didn't do smicha, so it's mechaper, but it's not fully mechaper, loy kipper. So there's a kapara, but not to the fullest extent. And also, chiluk de ritzui chatos va'oilo. There's a difference between what a karbon chatas comes to accomplish, to be mechaper on the chet b'sheigig, and then there's the oilo that follows after that, which is like a person that brings a gift after he already brought the karbon to appease the king even further. So that's a deeper level of a kapara, a deeper level of appeasing the king. So we see that there are various levels of how Hashem, to what degree Hashem accepts the karbon. V'oid, and other examples where we see different levels. U'bezeh ha'chiluk ben ha'mishneh v'agamore. And this is the difference between what the Mishnah is focusing on, when it says the statement Echod Amar Bevechod Amamit, and what the Gemara is focusing on. Be Mishnah, when the Mishnah says the statement Hamedubber Beinyanayu Pu'ulasaya Ikri Shel HaKarbon, the Mishnah is talking about the main purpose and the main effect of what a carbon is. Kifish Niskabel Amayla, the way it's being accepted by the Eibishter. That's the main point of a carbon, to bring a carbon for the Eibishter. So therefore the Mishnah is proving that the Karbonis, Marbe and the Mamet are both the same from Ishereich Nechoyach. Af, Shezeh Marbe, Vezeh Mamet. One is bringing a large carbon and one is bringing a small carbon. So what's the main thing the Mishnah is focusing on? The way this carbon is being accepted above by the Eibishter, kulam shavim, they're all the same. Whether the person brings a large or small carbon, the Eibishter accepts it the same way. That's the chiddush over here. Unlike when it comes to a melech basav adam, you bring a melech basav adam, a person brings a large gift, it's accepted in one way. You bring a smaller gift, it's accepted in a different way. But the Eibishter wants the kavana, the mechavan libel l'shamayim. So whether you bring a large carbon, whether you bring a small carbon, the Eibishter accepts them the same if he's mechavan libel l'shamayim. That's what the Mishnah is focusing on, the acceptance by the Eibishter. Now the Rebbe says, what is a carbon? V'hine, ba'akravas ha'karbon tzarech liya yizgam akravas ha'adam. When a person brings a carbon, so he's bringing also from himself. Al derech ma'shanem al ritzoinchem. Ritzoinchem, that it should be to your satisfaction. When a person brings a carbon, there's literally the investment financially that he's bringing in this carbon. But besides that, as the Ramban says, the blood that you sprinkle on the Mizbeach, a person should envision this to be his blood, it's instead of him. And nefesh tachas nefesh chulo. His nefesh is instead, the nefesh of the carbon that is instead of his nefesh. So when a person brings a carbon, what is being accepted by the Eibishter? It's not only the carbon, it's the nefesh of the person that's being accepted. U'bakravas ha'adam. So when a person brings a carbon, harei dafke b'karbon mincha nema nefesh kisakriv. Looking at the fact that a carbon is not only about the behemah or about the oif or about the mincha, but it's also the person that's giving from his nefesh to the Eibishter. Where does the Torah write the expression of nefesh kisakriv, ki'ilu hikriv nafshoi, as if he was makriv his nefesh? It says it by karbon mincha. Rashi brings it in Al HaTorah. A karbon mincha, which is talking about a poor individual, that for him it's so difficult to bring a karbon, and he brings a karbon mincha that's more precious to the Eibishter because he's bringing from his soul. He's bringing something that's difficult for him to bring. So we see that the mamet, the person that brings a smaller karbon, there's an advantage by his karbon more than the marbe. Mechadish kara. So here the pasuk comes in as mechadish. Shagami karbon behemah va'oiv. Even a person that brings a large karbon, a behemah or a oiv. The Eibishter accepts it the same like the Mamet. So now, the Rebbe with this answered the first question of the Sicha. Why does the Mishnah say, Echod Amarbe ve'Echod Amamet? Because there's a Chiddush on both sides. There's a Chiddush on the Mamet. If you look at the actual carbon, this is a Behemet, this is a Oif, and this is a Mincha. The Mincha is much smaller. So the Chiddush is that even though the actual carbon, the Mincha, is much smaller, it's accepted the same like a person that brings a big Behemet. But if you look at the nefesh in the carbon, when a person brings a carbon, he's supposed to envision that he himself is being given as a carbon. So the nefesh of the poor man that brings a carbon in the mincha is much more than the marbe, than the person bringing a large carbon. So therefore the chiddush is the other way around, that even the marbe, the Eibishter accepts it the same way as the mamet, as long as it's mechaven libel l'shamayim. This is all explaining the pshat in the Mishnah. Mishnah is focusing on the Eibishter accepting the Karbonis equally with the full shlemus the same by both. Then comes an additional point in the Gemara. The Gemara asks the question, my korom, what's the pasuk? What's the source for this idea? And here, the Gemara is looking for a source for another aspect of this inyan. There's another detail that we're going to prove from a pasuk in this idea of Echad Amarba. She'ena mochach ma'akasav amuva b'mishnah, which is not proven from the pasuk that it's brought in the Mishnah. And v'hu, what detail are we looking at? She'gamba vos ha'karbin she'mitzad ha'odam ha'mevi ha'karbin, even from the perspective and from the angle of the person below that's bringing the karbin, ein afresh ben amarba v'amamet. The person should not distinguish between one person that comes with a large behemah and another person that comes with a small carbon flower. There's no distinction even mitzad the person, because the main ingredient mitzad the person below is also the kavana. So not only does the Eibishter on his own decide to accept both equally, but also mitzad the person below, they are the same. The large carbon and the smaller carbon, they are really the same, because the main ingredient of the carbon is the kavana, and therefore they're the same. How does the Gemara know that they are considered to be the same, even mitzad the person below? Maybe only the Eibishter Lamaila accepts both of them equally, but who says mitzad the person below, it's considered to be the same thing? And it's obvious to Rab Zeira and the Gemara that this is the case, that even mitzad the person below, they're considered to be the same. And the question, the only question of the Gemara is, what's the source for the fact that they are the same? Since the main ingredient of a carbon is not the physical behemoth that you bring, the main ingredient of the carbon is the kavana l'shamayim. So it makes sense to say that if you had the proper kavana b'shleimus, gama havo shel hakarbon shemitzad ha'odam amam et shleimai. So even the person that brings a smaller carbon, it's a shleimizik carbon, even though physically what he's bringing is smaller, but the main ingredient of the carbon, the kavana, is the same. So if l'gabi the acceptance of the Eibishter above, it's accepted the same, whether you have a large carbon or a small carbon, because the Eibishter is looking at your kavana, and that's accepted the same. So it makes sense to say that if that's the main ingredient of a carbon, then when we look at the action of the person, we don't focus on the physical size of the carbon, but we focus on the kavana in your heart. That's the main thing, even mitzad the person below. And the rest does not matter as much. So here the Gemara brings a pasuk to prove the idea, even mitzad the person below. V'krab v'negeil ha'adam, mevi Rab Zeira b'gemara, so Rab Zeira's source is, ma'akosav m'sukash nasa oivid d'ma'at v'imhar b'yoichal, she'ha'oivid, when the pasuk here talks about the worker, koyel ha'adam ha'mevi karbon, it's talking about the person bringing the carbon, k'mosh ha'pirish ha'ashi, that it refers to the person. Ashashnasai shel ha'oivid m'sukah, his sleep of this person is a sweet im'at v'imhar b'midoshava, and the same, Bein shakarbon mad, bein harbe, whether it's a large carbon, whether it's a small carbon, yoichal mat nischora, he gets the same reward. Reish and mikasov zay alfina shegam mitzad ha'oivid ein chilek ben amarbe v'amamet. Even mitzad the person below, mitzad the action that he's doing, don't focus on the physical aspect of what he's doing. Focus on the main part of the carbon, which is the kavana, and therefore it's the same by whether large or small carbon. Bravada bara v'oimer. Hakasuv, the pasuk says, if you have a bigger carbon, so there's more food, but there's no advantage here. There's no advantage to the owner. The point that this pasuk is saying is, there's no advantage to the owner of the carbon, which is the person here below, by bringing a larger carbon. Shamar b'karbonai. Again, the point that the Gemara is proving, both Rab Zeira and Avada Bar Ave, is not mitzad the acceptance above, but mitzad what the person is doing. That what the person is doing below, the main ingredient of his carbon, of his action, is his kavana, not the physical size of the carbon. This will explain also the connection of the end of the Masechta to the beginning of the Masechta. Also in the beginning of the Masechta, we're going to see the two aspects of the carbon, the acceptance of Hashem above and the avodah of the person below. So the Mishnah begins, all of the menachos, if you took the kmitza and you did it shalay lishma, it's kosher. You can be makriv on the mizbeach. However, the owner of the carbon, if he had a certain chayva to bring this mincha, he wasn't yaitzeh chayv. He's going to have to bring another carbon mincha again. The first Mishnah is also discussing and distinguishing between the two aspects of a carbon. There's kashros a carbon mitzad atzmai. There is the carbon itself. It should be accepted by the Eivishter. Like the Indian that's discussed in the last Mishnah of Menaches, discussing the Reich Nechayach Lashem over here as well, we're discussing the kashrus of the carbon, that even if it's Shalay Lishma, it's accepted, it's kasher. But then there's V'chayvus HaBailam B'avos HaKarbon. There's the obligation of the person, the action and his obligation that he does from below. And here the Mishnah says that if it was done Shalay Lishma, then he's not Yetzeh Eschiv. So the Mishnah is making a distinction between the way it's accepted above and the way a person is doing his Chayva below. In connection with this, you have the siyum of the mesechta. Although there are these two aspects in a carbon, and one is not always necessarily dependent on the other, it's a kosher carbon, but the person wasn't yaitze his chiyuv. But atzad hashava shebishneihem, the tzad hashava of both aspects of the karbonis are hein legabi reich nechayach la'avayi ve'hein legabi adam ha'makriv echad ha'mabe ve'echad ha'mamet u'bavad she'yichavan libi l'shamayim, that the main ingredient of the carbon is the kavana of the person, and that is the same by the marbe and the mamet, and therefore it's accepted above the same way. U'kanal d'ma mishneh muvan b'pashtus, and then from the mishneh you understand the gamitzada adam are echad amarbe. If that's the main ingredient that causes the Eivish to accept it, so mitzad the person below, mitzad his action, this is also the main ingredient of the carbon and not the size of the behemoth, large or small. Now, as we finished over here, the difference between the Mishnah and the Gemara, what the Mishnah is focusing on and what the Gemara is focusing on, the Rebbe will continue on, b'negeya to the Braisa. Abshim ben Azai. What are the 3 points that Abshim ben Azai is discussing in the Braisa? In Sif Dalid, the Rebbe is going to focus on the first point of Rabshim ben Azai, that the Torah writes the same name Avaya by all Karbonis, Shalei Litten Pischem Pele Baldin Lachlek, to say that there's more than one God, Chas V'Shalom. It only says the name Avaya by all Karbonis. So the Rebbe explains Chidushe Shel Rav Shimon ben Azai, who the Chiddush of Rav Shimon ben Azai is as follows. Dimeyois Shekama Sugim B'Karbonis. There are different categories of Karbonis. And the Rebbe here brings the two opposite ends of the spectrum. Yeshnam Haboim LaKapore Kamechatos Oshem Chulod. There are those Karbonis that are being brought for a Kapore. Shem Boim LaRatzis Esmidis Adin Shel Maila. It's coming to appease the Midis Adin by the Eibishter. Asher Al Kain. The appropriate name of the Eibishter here would have been the name of Elikim, the name of judgment. The Yeshnam on the other end of the spectrum, Karbanas Abom B'Turei Dol, Achesad Anasam Odom, the Karbanas that a person brings to thank the Eibishter for the kindness, Karban Teide, a Karban Teide to thank the Eibishter, Kamoikin Karbanas Shemivim B'Kesh L'Yin Shal Simcha, the Karbanas that are brought in connection to any Simcha, Kama Shalmi Simcha V'Chulu that you bring on a Yom Tov, Uvahem Halei Masam Hashem Keil, Amir Al Achesed. The name should have been Kael, connected to Chesed. Mishkas of Chesed, Kael, Kol Hayom. Ve'im Kol Zeh. So although there are different types of Karbanos from one extreme to another, Le'metzina b'chol ha-Karbanos, El Hashem Havaya. You only find one name, the same name Havaya by all Karbanos. What's the reason for this? Havaya Tam Adavor. So here Rav Shimon ben Azai, it comes and explains this. In other words, Rav Shimon ben Azai is sort of answering a question. We would have expected that since the Karbanos are so radically different from each other, they're not all coming to accomplish the same thing, you would have expected that it should be also seen in the different names used for the Karbanos for the different things that it's coming to accomplish. So he comes to explain why it always has the same name. Shalei Litten Pischem Peh LeBaldin Lachlek. Not to give an opening for a Baldin to come and argue that there's more than one God. That would be the simple pshat of the Gemara. So the Rebbe clarifies, no, it's not, it doesn't come to say that he's going to argue that there's more than one God. We're not coming to negate the person that has the opinion that there's more than one God in the literal sense, Chas V'Shalom. Because then, as the Rebbe pointed out in the beginning of the Sikha, we wouldn't call this person a Baldin, he's Tama Kaifer. Ella, rather, there's a much more subtle mistake that this person is making. The kavan over here is this person that thinks there's only one creator to the world. There's no second. Within the one creator, there's more than one aspect to his existence. There's the chesed within the Eibishter, which is one aspect to his existence. Then you have judgment, which is another aspect to his existence. Just like it is by a human being. Which is made up of many different middos in him. If so, if the Torah would relate one category of karbanos to a name, kale. Suga masim l'shem zeh, the name that's befitting for these karbanos. And then the suga achel l'shem elakim, another category relating to shem elakim. So then I nitn pischem peh lo hanachosu shel ha-baladin lo'ima. So there's an opening, there's at least a pischem peh for this idea that this baladin is saying, kirishu yis harbehein, beha echod l'mayla. The one God has two different aspects to his existence, and each one of the karbanos relates only to one aspect. And the individual carbon only relates and connects to only one aspect of Hashem's existence. And this, of course, is not true. And the Eibishter is one simple unity, one simple existence without different aspects that make up his existence the way it is by a human being. This subtle mistake, we're not talking about a mistake where a person thinks that there's more than one creator, but we're talking about a mistake that the person thinks that the Eibishter is made up of different aspects, he's a murkav of different aspects. So this is seen b'diyak aloshin. Pischem peh lebaldin lachlik, that the baldin wants to be chaylik. That's all the Gemara says. The Gemara doesn't say anymore. Lachlik. The mistake that this baldin is making is that there could be room for separation and various aspects of Hashem's existence, and each carbon only connects to one aspect of Hashem's existence. That's his mistake. So in order that you shouldn't think that there are more than one aspect of Hashem's existence, although all these karbanos are very different in what they are coming to accomplish, but all of them have the same name, Rak Shem Echad, one name of the Eibishter, V'dafke Shem Havaya, and specifically the Shem Havaya. Kishem Havaya, Shem HaMufurish, Shem HaEtzem, Shem HaMiyuchid, this is the essence of the Eibishter, HaMeirish Hashem Yizbarach, Ulamayla Mekolin Shashini V'Yizchalkos, which teaches us the fact that the Eibishter himself is completely above any separations, any aspects, any divisions. And v'zeh gufa malam deinu, and now this itself teaches us, the mash ha-metzinu is chalkas ba-shemais, the fact that we find various names of the Eibishter, hurak yipnei shalafi maisai ani nikra, the actions of the Eibishter, the way the Eibishter comes out and expresses himself in action as he relates to creation, there there's more than one name. The way the Eibishter appears and acts and engages with us in his actions, the Eibishter's ashpa on the world is more than one. Is many, many different actions and hashpa that the Eibishter brings to the world. But not, God forbid, that there's any ischalkus whatsoever in the very existence of the Eibishter himself. The Eibishter is one, and therefore the Torah over here regarding karbanis, where there are so many different kinds of karbanis from one extreme to another, and still it uses only one and the same name, to teach me that the various different aspects of the Eibishter is only as far as how he relates to us. But as far as the Eibishter himself is concerned, the Eibishter is it's all one and the same name of Shem Havaya. Atam shadavka b'karbonis. The reason why specifically regarding karbonis, hutzrach hakasav lohaitzim yipischam peh shel habaldin, why is it over here dafka by karbonis that you have to come and clarify, not like this idea that the Baldin says that the Eibishter has more than one aspect to his existence. This mistake comes up more than by karbanos. Even though l'chayri you could argue that you have similar by all other mitzvahs, you have different types of mitzvahs from one extreme to another. So why doesn't the Torah bother clarifying this point when you get it to other mitzvahs as well, that it's all the same God that says all the mitzvahs? Just like by Karbanos, that you have different extremes of Karbanos, and it says the one name that they're all coming from the same Eibishter. Because there's another aspect to Karbanos where this mistake could be made dafke by Karbanos. And the reason is as follows. In Yonam Shala Karbanos, who live for Shinu Vitoisus Ratzin Kaviyachala Mailo, unlike all other mitzvahs, the whole idea of a carbon is to accomplish a change by the Eibishter's will above. To bring a smell, a good smell to the Eibishter, to bring about a shini l'mayla by the Eibishter. Specifically, when it comes to the karbanis, that the point of these karbanis is to be mechaper on a chet of a person. The person was over on the Eibishter's ratzen. The whole point of a karban is that it should be accepted by the Eibishter. That's what a karban is all about. That the karbanis is in order that the Eibishter should accept it and it should forgive the person. So a karban is not just fulfilling Hashem's will, doing a mitzvah. The karban has an accomplishment that it causes a change above by the Eibishter, a change in attitude. We see by Noach, he brings a karban oil after the mabul. That the Eibishter says that I will not curse the human being again because he has an evil inclination and it's not his fault. The Eibishter sees the evil inclination of a person. That itself was the reason for the mabul. The carbon that Noach brought a change in the Eibishter's attitude regarding the very same reason that caused the Eibishter to bring the mabul. Now this is the very same reason that the Eibishter is not going to bring a mabul again. So we see a carbon has a great effect l'mayla to change the Eibishter's attitude. If karbanis has the power to bring about such a kind of a change, so by karbanis, more than any other part of Torah, there's a room for a person to come and say that within the Eibishter's existence there are various attitudes, there are various aspects to his existence. The change of attitude comes from the change of the source, whether it's chesed, whether it's din, whether it's kale, whether it's elikim. So here, there's a room to say that there's different aspects to Hashem's existence. Over here, dafke by karbanis, the Torah did not want to write more than one name of Hashem because the Torah was worried that that might give an opening for a baldin to say that there's more than one aspect to Hashem's existence. So therefore, specifically here, the Torah says havaya. Shushema etzem, shema mafurish. That shows on the oneness, on the simple unity of the Eibishter. When you bring a carbon, you're bringing the carbon to Shem Havaya. Although karbanis have various accomplishments and it causes a change of attitudes above, but all karbanis are being brought and are accepted by the Eibishter himself, and the Eibishter himself is above any ischalkus whatsoever. So this explains the first concept that Rav Shimon ben Azai said in the Braisa. That the main point over here is that this is a special inyan b'negeya to Karbanis, that I would think that Karbanis shows that there's more than one aspect to Hashem's existence, and dafke by Karbanis, we have to clarify that, and the Torah writes one name to say that the Eibishter is Achdus Pshuta. Now the Rebbe continues to the second point that Rav Shimon ben Azai says, and explains the connection and the flow from the first to the second point. We could now understand the flow and the connection of the first point in the Braise to the second point, Shabon Emar, where he repeats what it says in the Mishnah. Mishnah, seemingly the same like it says in the Mishnah. So what's the Hemshech? After the Braise finishes explaining in the first statement, that there's no difference, there's no levels of where, how far, how high the karbanis reach. became a shekulam am l'shem avaya. All karbanas that Ayid brings goes directly to the Eibishter himself. And therefore it only says the name avaya. So the first statement in the Braisa of Rav Shimon ben Azai is dealing with how far l'mailo the karban reaches. So here comes the second statement of Rav Shimon ben Azai. Lishlo gam suk sheni shel schalkas bein karbanas mitzad adam v'akir l'mato. To negate another kind of separating in categories that a person would think mitzad the way the carbon is being brought below. She'ein hefresh bein amarbe v'hamamet. That don't distinguish between a carbon that's large or a carbon that's small, but kamas a carbon. Don't look at the size of the carbon, but ubulvachi yichavanas libel hashamayim. All the carbonas are the same. As long as you have the same kavana l'shamayim, it's all the same. So the first part of the braisa is talking about that all carbonas reach l'mayla, the same. And the second statement in the braisa is talking about the carbon l'matam, mitzad the person, that although there's a large carbon and there's a small carbon, but mitzad the person below, it's all the same if he has a kavana l'shamayim. Similar, this the two statements of the Braise here is similar to what we explained before when the Gemara asks the question, my kara, even though the Gemara is coming following the Mishnah and the Mishnah already brought a pasuk for this inyan of Echad Amar Bevechad Amar Bevavashi Yechav and Libel HaShemayim. Shakavonihi, so we explained earlier, what is the Gemara asking? Minale bikra shigamitzad ha'odam ha'makriv en hevdo be'mar bevamamet. The Gemara's question is, how do we know that even mitzad the person below, it's the same? Marva and Mamet are the same. So that's the what it's adding to the Mishnah. The Mishnah is talking about mitzad l'mayla, and the Gemara is talking about mitzad l'mata, mitzad the person. So kach gam bebraise, the same is also when it comes to the braise. Shen yon olo vayres hashoni b'mishnah b'loshen k'tzara iberemez. What's written in the Mishnah, in short, or even only as a hint, is clarified and elaborated upon in the braise. Ikirat goshi hi boi sofa la Mishnah shegam mitzad ha'odam ha'makriv ein l'chalek ben amar b'vamamet. The braise is coming to add that not only mitzad l'mailo, but mitzad the person that's bringing the carbon, don't make a distinction mitzad the size of the carbon physically, because the main thing is what's in his heart, and therefore the marbe and the mamet are the same. So based on this, that the braise is speaking about the person below, medayik ba braise neme b'sheir agas b'oif adak u'b'mincha chulu b'shini b'loshna mishnah. Therefore it switches from the loshna of the mishnah, and it says a large shayr, a small bird, and not like it said in the mishnah, neme b'oilas b'heima b'oilas ha'oif. The Mishnah uses the term that the carbon, the oila behema, the ba'ila oif. It doesn't talk about the actual behema or the oif. What's the difference? So b'mincha, heyayis. The difference between the lashon of the Mishnah and the lashon of the Braise is heyayis va'mishnah mavares es hashivim ben amar bevamamet kifishu mizbata bakravosa valiyosa shel carbon la'avaya. The Mishnah is talking about the difference between a large carbon and a small carbon and the way it's being accepted by the Eibishter above. So therefore it says in the Mishnah, Oilas behema, Oilas oif, Shah oili kula kalal al mizbeach. And oila is being brought and being burnt completely on the mizbeach for the Eibishter. Kula la kadosh baruch hu, completely for the Eibishter. Hainu shishiyurim, shishiyurim shalaribui vahamiyatu bekamas ha'akrov al mizbeach. The Mishnah is focusing on what's being burnt and brought in the mizbeach for the Eibishter. The bein oilas behema, shiikol bekamusa merube, whether it's oilas behema that is fully burnt and it's a larger carbon that's being burnt, bein oilas ha'oiv shakol shalo pchusa habe bekamusa, or whether it's a bird that much less of it is being burnt on the mizbeach, ubein mincha, and even a mincha shitachlas hamid bekarbas ha'akrov al avaya, it's much smaller, much less, bekivin she'ein ha'kol, because it's not being burnt fully on the mizbeach, al sherak ha'kaimitz b'mena nikter al mizbeach, there's only one small kaimitz that's burnt on the mizbeach. B'chol echad behen nema isherech nechayach loyim alecha echad amarbe b'vhad sheyichavim. So the Mishnah is focusing on the oila aspect, on what's being burnt and what's being brought on the mizbeach, that it's the same by the Eibishter. Aval bevraise, koi she'echad amarbe v'echad amarbe d'gabi yodam amakriv. The braise is speaking about the person below. That look at what the person is doing. There's different aspects to what he's doing. There's the physical aspect, and then there's what is in his heart. And the Mishnah is saying, don't focus on the physical of what he's bringing, focus on what's in his heart. The Mishnah switches from the Lashon of Oila, because as far as the person is concerned, there's no difference how much of it is burnt on the Mizbeach. He's giving it all away to the whether the Mizbeach or to the Kayanim. The Lashon Amata'eres as Gaidloi Gasusai Shalakarban Atzmoi. The Mishnah comes and describes the actual size of the carbon itself. Nema b'sheira gas u'bo'ira oifadak. That there's a large bull and there's a small bird. Mekiv v'shad goshem mitzada makriv. Here we're looking at what the person is bringing, what he's actually bringing into the Beis HaMikdash. Harei masim bo yashir b'gasas v'dakas shel ha'karbon gufa. Here we're focusing on the size of the carbon, whether it's large or small, and we're telling you, don't look at what's large or small, look at what's going on in his heart, that he's doing it for the Eibush's sake. So in this sif, the Rebbe explained the second point that Rav Shimon ben Azai said in the Braise, Echad Amabe v'Echad Amamit, and we answered that he's not repeating the same thing as the Mishnah. The Mishnah is focusing on the way the Eibushter accepts it. The Braise is focusing on the way the person brings it, that the person is bringing everything that it's the same. And this flows from the first statement of Rav Shimon ben Azai. The first statement of Rav Shimon ben Azai is saying, don't make any distinctions in karbanis mitzad lamayla, because it all goes to Havaya. And the second statement says, also, don't make a distinction in the karbanis mitzad lamata, the way the person brings it here below. The Rebbe continues. Continuing, on the second statement of Rav Shimon ben Azai. However, Zesha Braisa Matgisha Shivin Lagaba Yadama Makriv, the Braisa is coming to explain and emphasize that the person bringing the carbon, it's all equal. Ain Zerach Lefisha Bala Hisif Oit Pratala Amab Mishnah. He's not only coming to add an additional detail to the Mishnah that the Mishnah did not focus on. Ella, rather, it goes even deeper than this. Lefisha Ladaita Shalab Shimon Ben Azai, Zeo Pirish Ubira Mishnah Atzma. This is the pshat of the Mishnah itself. As the Rebbe brought before, a braisa comes to clarify and elaborate upon what it says in the Mishnah. Rav Shimon ben Azai is not just coming to add a detail that it does not say in the Mishnah, but he's clarifying the Mishnah itself. What's the pshat? Didn't we explain that the Mishnah is focusing on lamayla, how it's being accepted above, and Rav Shimon ben Azai is focusing, like the Gemara before, Rav Zeira and Avada Bar Ave, they're focusing on the person below, what the person is doing. So the Rebbe explains, the ime yais shiyesh b'karb mishnei on yonim. What Rav Shimon ben Azai is telling us is, yes, it's true that a carbon has two aspects to it. Kvishu mitzad HaKadosh Baruch Hu, kvishu mitzad HaAdam HaMakriv. Looking at the carbon from the angle of the Eibishter and looking at the carbon from the angle of the person below. Kanal. But harei l'amitay shel davar. The truth, however, is, gam inyan ha-reich nechayach shel mitzad HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the whole reich nechayach, mitzad HaEibishter, that he accepts the carbon. What's the point of it here? Harei tachlisei u'matarasei b'shvil HaAdam HaMakriv. The purpose of the Eibusha accepting the carbon is for the benefit of the person. It's the person that gets the kapara, and now the Eibusha is appeased to be able to accept the person again. So therefore it makes sense to say, every aspect of a carbon, whatever you look at a carbon, including when you're looking at a carbon, mitzad how the Eibishter accepts it above, what you have to pay attention is how the person is bringing it from below. Hayais, the whole point of a carbon is that the person below should be, have a kapara, should be accepted by the Eibishter. So although seemingly you could divide two separate things, and the Rebbe brought before a source for this, that you could have a carbon that's kosher mitzad le Eibishter, but the person below, there wasn't yaitzis chiv. But nevertheless, hayais, the whole purpose of a carbon, the Eibishter accepting that is, the purpose of the Eibishter accepting it is that the person should be forgiven. So even when we talk about the Eibishter accepting it, what you have to look at is how the action is being done from the person below. So this is the reason why the Braisa, although the Braisa is focusing on the person below, it still brings the pasuk Ishereich Nechayach Kfishar Carbon Mekubal Amayla, how the carbon is being accepted above. Even though the Braisa is focusing on the person below, as the Rebbe pointed out before, Shreira Gas. Oifadak, that proves that the Braisa is speaking about the person below. Still, it brings the pasuk that talks about how the Eibishter accepts the carbon. Why doesn't the Braisa bring the psukim that the Gemara brought, Mesukah Shnas Oivid, or the pasuk of Makishon Lebaleo, focusing on the person below? So the reason is, adarabe, on the contrary, this teaches us something deeper. The fact that by the Eibishter, the Marbe and the Mamet are the same, this itself proves that the effect on the person is also the same. The whole Reich Nechayach by the Eibishter is dependent on the person and it's for the purpose of the person. The whole carbon is all for the purpose of the person. So if it's being accepted Lamaila by the Eibishter in the same way, so that means that the person below is being forgiven in the same way. So from this that it's being accepted Lamaila, automatically we understand that it's also the same Lagabi, the action of the person below. Now that Rebbe leads us into the third aspect of the Braise, the third statement in the Braise. The third thing that comes in connection to what it says before. And if you're going to say that the Eibishter needs food to eat. So first the Rebbe clarifies. We're not coming to negate that there's no concept of achila lamayla in the literal sense. We're not talking about physical food. There's godly food. Could look come on, as Rebbe will soon explain. There's no need to negate physical eating, physical food by the Eibishter, kanal, as the Rebbe asked before in the beginning of the Sicha. What the Braise is coming to clarify is spiritual food, there is lamayla. Still, the Eibishter does not rely on us, and he does not need us for this spiritual food. And this third statement in the Braise here is a continuation of what it said before. The whole union of a carbon is all for the purpose of the person. It's not for the purpose of the Eibishter. Even this that the Eibishter accepts the carbon above is in order to affect a kapara for the person below. So behemshich to this, we're going to also understand the spiritual eating of the carbon lamayla, that it's all for the purpose of the person and not for the purpose of the Eibishter. The Yuvon, this will be understood, Bahaktim Biyarin Achila Lamaila, the Rebbe in Siv Zayin, will first explain what is this concept of spiritual eating by the Eibishter. So far the Rebbe explained the first part of the Braise, the Rebbe explained the second part of the Braise. There's no chilukim in a carbon lamaila, it all goes straight to Avaya, and also Lamato, there's no chilukim in the size of the carbon, it's all the same thing, it's all Chavan Libel Hashamayim, and therefore it's either person Lamato, it's the same. And then the Rebbe added a deeper point that a yais even mitzad lamayla, the carbon that's being accepted is for the purpose of the person. So if by the Eibishter it's accepted the same, it's from that automatically understood that mitzad the person below it's also the same. But now the Rebbe is going to continue into the third part of the Braisa. Yisa b'sefri, it says in the Sefri in Parshas Pinchas. B'tams michuso shol Parshas atomod l'bakoshes Moshe yifkoid Hashem goyme isha le'eda sheyetzel lefneim v'sheyovel lefneim. First, in the Torah there, it says that the Eibishter, Moshe Rabbeinu, that is, asks the Eibishter before he passes away, please appoint a person, a leader on Klal Yisrael that will take them in, bring them out, and so on. And then right after that comes the Parsha Satome, the Parsha of Karbonis. What's the connection between the two points? So the Medrash says as follows. Moshul l'mad davadayna. L'melech sh'oise ishtay nefteres min olam. A king and the queen is passing away from the world. And she's giving him instructions of how to take care of the children. So the king says to the queen, instead of you giving me instructions how to take care of my children, tell my children of how they should listen to me and how they should take care of me. They shouldn't rebel against me. So the same thing happens here. Instead of you coming and telling me that I should see to it that my children, the Yidden, should have a leader, tell my children that they should bring karbanas. Tell them what they have to do for me. That the Yidden shouldn't be disgraceful to me. The Yidden should give me the proper honor and bring me karbanas. So there's a connection here. There's a connection between appointing a leader upon Klal Yisrael, and then the Eibishter says, similar to that, tell the Yidden to bring karbanas for me. What's the connection? Divrei HaMedrash muvan sheparshas v'inyan haTamid yesh lekisher v'dimyan la'toichem bakashas Moshe yifkod Hashem v'gomer. There's a connection between the Karbonis and the Eibishter asking, and Moshe Rabbeinu asking the Eibishter to appoint a leader. Since, as we see, the response of the Eibishter to Moshe Rabbeinu's request, the Kamuv Mishuzer Gam Milia Bakasha, it's understood that this is also part of the Eibishter fulfilling his request. Who Parshas HaTamid? So the Eibishter brings the Parshas HaTamid as a response to his request to appoint a leader. Shub Kaid Bonei Alai, this is what you should ask the Yidden, my children, to do for me. Instead of what you're asking me to take care of my children. So there has to be a connection here. What's the connection? So first the Rebbe explains what exactly it is that Moshe Rabbeinu was requesting of the Eibishter. The request of Moshe Rabbeinu from the Eibishter in the simple sense is as follows. Yesh b'nei Yisrael nechnasim la'aretz, Yidna gonna enter into Eretz Yisrael. Yesh tzayrich sheyismane ish ala'eda sheyetz lefneim v'ashiyav lefneim. So they need a leader that should go out ahead of them and should do all the matters for the Yidin. Sheyamet b'reishim b'melchome b'kibish ha'aretz, that should be guiding them and going ahead of them and conquering the land. V'yanhiga machakach b'chol inyanein, and conduct all matters in their life. V'loy tia adas Hashem k'tzayn ha'shein lo'yroya, and that the nation of the Yidin should not be like sheep without a shepherd. That's the simple pshat of what Moshe Rabbeinu requested. So if so, we understand. So the response of the Eibishter, that the Eibishter says to bring Karbanis, is similar to what Moshe Rabbeinu requested of the Eibishter. The Eibishter is requesting from Yidden. Bringing Karbanis negates the mistake that there's no shepherd to this world. The world just goes on by nature on its own. And a person can make the mistake to think that you have a huge palace, you have a huge world here without any leader. By bringing the Talmud and all the Karbanis, that the Eibush is the one that conducts all matters in the world. Everything happening in the world is happening through the Ashkacha Pratis of the Eibishter. By bringing Karbanis, you bring the presence of the Eibishter into the world, that everybody should see clearly that the Eibishter is the one that's conducting matters into the world. So just like Moshe Rabbeinu requests a leader for Klal Yisrael, the Eibishter requests of Moshe Rabbeinu to tell Yidden that they should bring Karbanis, so we should see that the Eibishter is the leader and the master of the universe. V'zeh gam ha'tam, this explains to us what spiritual food means l'mayla. V'zeh gam ha'tam, sh'akarbanis nikra lechem v'achila klapi mayla. Karbanis are called bread or food by the Eibishter. Moshe kosov karboni lachmi. It's the Eibishter's food. Ki yamre razal, it says in the Gemara, it says in the Medrash. Ha'nefesh azum m'mala esaguf. A person's soul fills his body, and the person is the Eibishter, that is the soul of the world, and he fills the world. So here we see the connection between food, why Karbanis is called food, like food by a human being. Just like when a person eats, and all the other needs of a person, what does it accomplish? This keeps a person healthy and brings the life of the soul in the body. If a person eats, so then he has the kayach and he has the health that he needs, that the body should feel the life of the soul in the guf to do whatever he has to. Same is also regarding the fact that the Eibishter fills the world. Shah karbanis the kram lechem v'achile, the karbanis accomplish what food and bread accomplishes. Ki heima poilim legalis boilim, what they accomplish is they reveal in the world. Shah kadosh baruch hu abalabayis lebirizu, they draw the soul of Hashem, they bring the presence of the Eibishter into the world. V'hanishati is chabris guluya shal er v'chayis leki boilim kanal, to draw and bring the energy of the Eibishter to be revealed in the world. Just like when a person eats, he draws the energy of his soul into his body to be healthy and strong. When a person brings a carbon, this is food for the Eibishter, kaviyachol, that you bring the energy and the source of chayis of the Eibishter into the world to be revealed for everybody to see. So now we know what achila of a carbon is, what the spiritual food of a carbon is. So now let's go back to the statement of the Braise, the third statement of the Braise. וזהו מה שאומר רב שמעון בן עזאי, בהמשך לשיטתוסי, following his chiddush that he said before, אשר כל עניין הקרבן. What's the whole purpose of a carbon? גם עניין הריח נחייך ובשביל האדם ולא תיבוסי. That the whole purpose of a carbon is all for the person. Even this that Eibush the Lamailo accepts the carbon, it's all for the person's kapara below. V'shaloi la'akshir saleo, so now, do not ask the following question. V'shem o'toyma la'achilo hu tzorich. Maybe you would think that the purpose of karbonis is all for the Eibush's sake. Hainu, why is it for the Eibush's sake? Maybe the Eibush is the one that needs the karbonis. It's not for the sake of the person. The Eibushter accepts it above for the kapot of the person below. Maybe you would ask and say, no, the Eibushter needs it. Why? He created this world with the desire to bring and make a dwelling for the Eibushter in this world. To reveal the presence of the Eibushter and to make a dwelling for the Eibushter in this world. Veim kein if so are ze machayev she yesh nimin achila la mayla shal yada kadosh baruch hu mamala sa ilam ba ifen shel chibur vegiloy. So then by bringing karbonis, you draw the presence of Hashem in this world and you accomplish His desire. He needs it. His desire that He created the world for, by bringing karbonis, you accomplish that. Vahare l'chayrish ha-achilas ha-karbonis yesh b'am gam tzarech kav yachal la-mayla. So there's a need for this, for these karbonis that the Eibushter needs. Not for you, but it's for Him. For His desire of the dira b'tachtayrim. Talmud Loimar, so the chiddush of the third statement in the Braise is, Im erav lo yaymaloch. If I have a desire, if I am hungry, I don't need you for this. Haynu she'ein hechrech kaviyachol b'shvil inyina achil ala mayla she'aymaloch. It's true that Eibushter has this desire, but there's no hechrech that He relies on us, that He needs us for this. Ki li se'evol umaloya, because the whole world belongs to me. Ve'ein hechrech she'inyina achila yavoy dafka yedei avedes ha-karbonis shel b'nei Yisrael. There's no hechrech that the dira b'tachtonim, that the Eibushter desires and needs kaviyachol, should be accomplished through Yidin. Elo she'inyina achila she'adei ha-karbonis l'toivas l'tayeles ha-odam. The fact that the Eibushter decided that the dira b'tachtonim should happen through the human being, through him bringing the karbonis, is all for the benefit of the person, to give him the privilege to do this. The Eibushter, in order to fulfill his desire of making a dira b'tachtonim, he doesn't have to rely on us. The Eibushter could accomplish that mitzad l'mailo. Mitzad our benefit, he wanted us to do this. So, this is the flow of the third point to the second point. Because in the second point, Rav Shimon ben Azar was mechadish, echad amrabe v'echad amamad, v'vachi yechav anlibu l'shamayim. And he brings the pasuk, ishe reyach nichayach, to say the point that all karbonis, even mitzad what they are l'mailo, the main point l'mailo of the ishe reyach nechayach of the Eibushter is the kavana and what the person is accomplishing below, what he's gaining from the karbonis. So at behemshuch l'zeh, he says that although there's l'chayra achila of a karbon and there's the Eibushter as a taiva of dira b'tachtonim, but nevertheless all of that he doesn't rely on us. The Eibushter does not need us for this. He can do it all on his own. The Eibushter gave us the privilege to be able to do this. V'zeh shemamshuch l'mesayim, and this is the conclusion of the b'raisa. You're not bringing the karbonis for my purpose, the carbon is for your satisfaction. So this explains the main point of what he's trying to say. This that we say that a large carbon, a small carbon, when it comes to the reich nechayach, the way the Eibushter accepts it, it's all the same. So vaday shekenu legabei adam. So most definitely, it's also the same regarding the person. Why? This is what Rav Shimon ben Azar is saying. The Eibushter has no gain of these karbanos for him. The reich nechayach l'mayla is all for you, that you should be forgiven. So therefore, bein she'evi shir gas, bein she'evi mincha, whether you bring a large shir, whether you bring a mincha, kiloy la'achila shal karbanos hu tzarech. And this is the next statement, the hemshech, because the Eibushter doesn't need this food. He's not relying on this for him, l'ritzayni. The chol tachalisam shal karbonis l'ritzaynchem. The whole tachlis of karbonis is for you, shal adam, for the person below. So if we're saying that the Eibushter l'mailo accepts all karbonis equally, by definition that means that the effect on the person below is also equal. Because that's the whole objective of the karbonis. The Eibushter l'mailo doesn't need any of the karbonis. The objective is the person below. The Rebbe concludes, siftes. However, although the Eibushter is not, nothing forces him to rely on us. He, so to speak, has a choice how he's going to accomplish the Dira B'Tachtayinim. The Eibishter did choose and did command that we should bring karbanis. Before the command. So the Eibishter has a choice. The Eibishter could decide how he wants to accomplish the Dira B'Tachtayinim, how he wants to accomplish the food that he needs. Once the Eibishter commands Yidden and says, I want your karbanis. This itself, the Eibishter chooses the Yidden's Aveda, shows how significant our Aveda is. The Eibishter commands us to do this carbon and all the karbanis. The Eibishter desires our Aveda in this world. The Eibishter commands and says that the Yidden should be there to do these mitzvahs and bring the karbanis. All the Torah mitzvahs in general are the idea of karbanis, to bring the Eibishter's presence into the world. To make everything in the world for a carbon for the Eibishter. This all makes a dira for the Eibishter in this world.